employed is a real public situation. In county, we have to really appreciate that. Eastside Fire and Rescue were the first ones up to me, and it took them 45 minutes to walk up to where I was. Then came King County Search and Rescue. They brought 40 volunteers to get me up that mountain. It took about 2 hours. It was incredible. And I'm down to one crutch, which is really great, and in a month I'm hoping to be on my own 2 feet. So it is really great to be here. The Bellevue business community understands that an excellent education supports our future workforce. To help students with ongoing learning opportunities, the Chamber has established the Bellevue Chamber Foundation Fund for these programs. Funding for our 2015 scholarships was made possible through the generous support of Washington Federal, our legacy sponsor for our 2014 Spirit of Bellevue Run and Walk, and other community partners who support education. This year, we were able to award $4,500 to 3 deserving Bellevue graduating seniors. We have amazing students in the Bellevue School District. I'm sure you all know that. I know this firsthand, participating in all the interviews this year. I'd like to thank the other business leaders who participated with me on the Foundation Scholarship Committee. Madeira Potts. Madeira, if you'll come up, she's going to help me. She is the Eastside Branch Manager with Washington Federal. And the Jenny Eng from the Vice President and Area Retail Leader of Kinney. Unfortunately, he's not able to be here today. But the three of us spent 2 half days interviewing students. We had about 22 applicants, which is pretty amazing. So, can we give a round of applause to the committee? Each applicant was exceptional. And what I'd like to challenge all of you with is to go back to your companies and see if you can budget in $1,500 to sponsor a scholarship for next year. You can give, if you can't do $1,500, give what you can to the foundation. Interviewing 22 kids, you realize there is so much talent out here in Bellevue. We need to give more. How about 10? What if we could give 10 scholarships next year? That would be fabulous. So you've got about 10 months to think about it and get your money together. So I'm going to charge each one of you with bringing on, being able to sponsor one more student. Okay? Can we do that? Yes? Okay. I'll take that as a big yes. So our first recipient is Lucas Pivet, graduating from Sammamish High School and receiving a Washington Federal Scholarship. He has selected the University of Washington as his educational institution of choice. Lucas plans to go into the area of life sciences and become a pediatric anesthesiologist because he knows firsthand the difficulties of dealing with many surgeries. In his application, he stated, "All of my doctors and other healthcare providers have been inspirational and dedicated towards helping me to reach my maximum potential. I aspire to do the same thing for children who are in need of help." He is an active leader in his school by being a part of his National Honor Society chapter, co-captain of the varsity swim team, and a link crew member. In addition, he has an intern and is a leader at the University of Washington Do It summer program, which supports high school students with disabilities. Through these experiences, Lucas has demonstrated his ability to help and lead others in a positive way. It's easy to tell by one of his teachers said, "He's not afraid to get in there and work to make the world a more equal and accepting place." We are so excited by Lucas's success, and we are sure he will continue to exceed expectations in the future. Let's congratulate him. Here. Could you stand up, please? A key graduate of Interlake High School, who will be attending the University of Miami with a provisional acceptance to the Miller School of Medicine and plans to become a physician. Karthik has shown to be a leader at school by becoming the vice president of his model of the United Nations, a participant in multiple honor societies, and his involvement in many other clubs such as DECA and Indian Culture Club. Most importantly, though, is his passion and desire to make a difference in the lives of patients and their families. His motivation to become a physician is driven by growing up with a younger brother with autism. He knew he wanted to give people hope the same way his doctors gave hope to his family. Because of this, he has shadowed many specialty physicians, assisted an occupational therapist, and for two summers in a row, interned at the National Institute of Health as a biomedic research intern to further his knowledge. He wrote, "I discovered how intrigued I was with the human body's symphony of inner workings, as well as the joy it gave me to care for me and interact with patients every day. There's no doubt about Karthik will continue to work hard, be a strong leader in this community, and will most definitely achieve his goals in the future." Let's congratulate Karthik. And guess what? His dad's here too. Ralph James Memorial Scholarship for a student pursuing a degree in business. It's awarded to Griffin Paulson. Griffin's graduated from Sammamish High School, and he'll attend the University of Washington with hopes of a dual major in business administration and industrial engineering. He explains that I can go forth confidently, knowing that my degree is widely applicable and will aid me throughout my career regardless. From a young child, 12, Griffin knew he wanted to pursue business, which later inspired him to start a DECA chapter at a school. The following year, his team attended and competed at internationals in Orlando. Griffin is sorry he could not be here today. He's one of those people that's on vacation. So I want to remind you about scholarships for next year. It'd be great if we could give out 10. So think about it. Talk to people in your company and see if you can participate with all of us. And congratulations to everyone that's receiving this. And I want to thank Mira. We've done this how many years ago?
Yep.
A couple more than that. But thank you, everyone.